welcome to our site. Now you're in for a treat. Tonight, Freida is going to be explaining her very unusual musical instruments, all made out of clay. Now some of these ideas go way back to the days of the early Aborigines. Well, she can explain it better than I can. And here she is.
Hi, everybody. I thought I would bring out some of my ceramic flutes and give you a little tour of my thoughts when I was in my ceramic class. Some of the ones that I made is I kind of fashioned them after an ocarina. This is an ocarina that was made by someone else, and I'll show you how it sounds a little bit. If I can get my fingers in the right place. Anyway, that's how an ocarina sounds. So I got this idea in my ceramic class that I would make some little flutes. Well, this turned out to be really not an easy thing to do because this little place where the air goes in and comes out has to be precisely correct. So I spent hours and hours doing this, but I did this in my ceramics class. This little guy I made, let's see if you can see it.
The Headless Horseman.
Jean calls it the Headless Horseman. I'll play it a little bit for you. It's got a deeper sound. Let me try that again.
Encore!
thank you very much. This is a little guy. So I think this is one of the very first ones I made. And let me play this little guy for you. Ta-da! And then this guy is a little bigger guy. Bigger guy. And I think he sounds kind of the same if I remember right. That's right. Then Jean helped me make this one. I made the flute, and then I asked Jean to help me put a face on there, a funny face. So that's the face right there. And this is not really like tuned or anything. It just has two little holes on the top. But like I said, this little end piece here, to get this precisely at the right angle, is just hard. A real good sound, but just I think this was one of the first ones I made too. So that's that. And then I had a class on extruding, and I see that Mariani, you have a extruder. So I was kind of jealous when I saw your extruder. So I decided that I would get into the more trumpet form and make a trumpet-like horn. I don't see. You can tell it's out of ceramics. And I'll play this a little bit for you. I hope the audio doesn't break on this. Are you ready, Gene? I'm pointing it right at you.
The cavalry are coming.
This one has the best. It hasn't got the best talent, but... But actually... Show you a little closer. I experimented with mixing marble. I forgot what the technique was called now, but mixing marble together. So there you go. Hope you can see that okay. Oh yeah, see the browns in there? That browns turned out pretty, I think. And then I went on to make my celadon trumpet horn. Putting this close up here so you can see. Although I have to look at the camera. I've just been talking about looking at the camera too much. And this has got a little better sound. That's hard to play for
me. And they're up and running.
And they're up and running. My poor dog over there. See, I can play the trumpet. That's about it, though. Okay, then I went into this very weird mood, and experimental musical instruments was our assignment. Well, I made that assignment up. My teacher's still back with the rest of the group making cups and bowls and things, so I guess I just got weird on this one. This one is extremely on the weird side.
Dr. Frankenstein.
Flute. The flute. Now, what I did was I thought, well, I'll make a bunch of orifices. Is that a correct pronunciation? Different kinds of holes to blow into to make different sounds. That's where it comes out. And I'd had some different sounds. This thing's heavy. And so it is not to be a real musical thing, but it does kind of work. And by the way, I had this out back, and when I was washing it off for this show, I held it up like this, and a black widow spider jumped right on my arm, scared the heck out of me, pulled my boob muscle. I'll tell you, I've never gotten over that yet. But listen to this. That's a terrible sound. That's a bad sound out of that one, and... You just can't make that pretty, no matter what. You can't. And then I actually got a little hold on here. So I would not call that successful, but I would call it...
Different.
It's on the really weird side. I'll put this strange one down. And then, of course, I decided to do something big, because I had a big extruder there at school. I had a great big thing on it. And we're also experimenting with mixing different colors to clay together. I can't remember the name of that technique. So on the bottom, I did some, marbleizing. I did some marbleizing on the bottom of my didgeridoo that I made. And then I did a different kind of marbleizing on the top. And that's the hole I blow into. And that's the hole it comes out of. Let's see if I can get this right. Supposed to like do this all in one breath endlessly, but my breath is short today. She's nodding off over there.
All the kangaroos have left the vicinity.
Here they come. Here comes the kangaroos. I like it. So anyway, that was a little of my ceramic moment in time in my little ceramic adventure. Thanks for joining me. Bye.